Twitch emotes are incredibly expensive when you're just starting out. And honestly, when we're talking about starting out, they're incredibly confusing as well. What size do they have to be? How do I make them? Where do I get them from if I can't make them? How do I upload them? It's just so much to cover and it can be a bit daunting, but fear not, because today I'm going to show you guys how to create your own free Twitch emotes and get them uploaded without any hassle. Let's go. Hey, my name is LJ from streamscheme.com. I'm also a variety streamer over at twitch.tv/LJM_. I'm most likely live right now. There's a link in the description. Now, if you were to check me out right now, then you would probably see my community using an emote, the LJ7 emote. The reason you'll most likely see this is because my community absolutely loves using that emote, and I'm gonna cover exactly how I made it in this video and get you guys up and running with some of your own awesome emotes. If you are unsure whether or not this video is for you, let me just explain that the very first emote I had commissioned to be made on my channel, that was 6 months ago when I reached affiliate, has been used over 8,570 times. That's LJ Hype, you should be able to see it on screen here. However, just one short month ago, I created my own emote using this exact method, and it has already been used over 11,000 times. So if you're a fresh affiliate, this video is definitely for you based off that, and I'll even reveal that emote to hopefully give you some ideas later in the video. So onto the first question you guys always seem to ask is, what emotes should I make when I reach affiliate, or just in general, what emotes should I make? Now, I think when it comes to making emotes, you should always stick with the core reactions. After all, they're emotions, they're emojis. So if you look at other streamers, they tend to cover the basics with their first slots of emotes, which is laughing, hype, fail, love, hello, or waving instead of hello is another one. And these tend to be a really good place to start. I will say here, when coming up with your emotes, whether it's laughing, failing, hyping, or whatever it's going to be, remember it has to be 112 pixels by 112 pixels. This means keep it simple. Think about your composition as a square and try and make sure that it's not too much detail. If there's too much detail, you're not gonna be able to see what it is. Once you've come up with the idea, it's about grabbing the core concept of your emote and removing the background. Now, I personally prefer photo emotes because I feel like they just add a bit more to my brand, but you can kind of do this with any imagery at all as long as you have the copyright to it, so keep that in mind. That said, when I ran polls with a few communities, talked to other streamers, and looked at some of the most used emotes of all time, most people do prefer photo emotes. So keep that in mind. I know it's everyone seems to go straight to Fiverr and get those drawn emotes, and that's great, but sometimes a photo emote actually does come out the best. If you're gonna use a photo emote, then grab yourself a smartphone or a good camera, get yourself into some nice even lighting. Make sure you don't blend in too much to your background because that'll just make it harder on you. Strike a pose and take a picture. So I'm just gonna remake LJ7, so. Cool, and I'm gonna screenshot that off the video and I'll show you guys the process using this. Once you have that image, I think it's really important to remove the background to make sure that your core stands out. If they're square emotes, it tends to make it a bit harder for people to see what's actually going on. So it's just a personal preference, but I do really feel like it works best. So there are two ways I can show you how to remove the background. The first is using Photoshop and the masking tool, which we'll cover. And the second is using a free website, which we will also cover, so don't worry. In the future, I do recommend trying to get some sort of program like Photoshop or GIMP. They're really, really great, and a little bit of graphic design will go a long way in your streaming career. That said, let's switch over to the computer and get into this. So first up, we're gonna do Photoshop. Open up Photoshop, drop your image in, select the quick select mask tool, you'll see it over here. Run it over the image, holding shift to pick up any bits you missed, and alt to remove stuff you don't want in it. Once you have it all selected, you hit this button down here, it is the mask button. It will give you a cutout. If it isn't quite right, you can grab this brush tool and click back on the mask. Use the brush tool with the color black to remove parts and use the brush tool with white to add it back in. So this will give you a bit of a play with, but if you own Photoshop and you can understand this method, try and just refine it and make it the best you possibly can, but that's a place to start. Now, if you wanna use the free method, that's fine. We're gonna do that right now, switching back over. So a website I found that's called remove.bg. It seems like it's a really good tool. What you'll do is you just upload your image, you let it run, and then you can edit it here with this brush tool. It's a much simpler method than say using Photoshop, but you do lose a bit of quality because of the upload and download process. And since we are gonna compress this file down to 112 pixels by 112 pixels, it means that we're gonna lose even more detail. So I do prefer to use Photoshop, but if you don't have it, this will work as well. On to the next stage, resizing your image down to 112 pixels by 112 pixels. Now, a lot of tutorials out there probably explain that you need to make a 58 pixel or a 26 pixel as well, or whatever the smaller ones are. However, thanks to Twitch's new uploading process, you just need the 112 pixel, which is awesome, and it'll resize the rest for you. Saves a lot of effort and a lot of time. So we're just gonna resize to 112. That said, if you do still want the other sizes, this method will work. You just don't use 112, you use the other sizes. But for now, just stick with the biggest size. So again, I have two methods. I've gone ahead and found a free method and a Photoshop method for you. I'm gonna cover Photoshop first and then the free method. Same thing as before. The free method will compress this down and you'll lose a bit of quality and the Photoshop version won't. So keep that in mind, but if you can't, just go with the free method and it'll still work fine for you. So open up Photoshop, click create a new project, then set a custom project size to 112 by 112. Make sure this is set to pixels. Change the background to transparent instead of white, and then click create. Now open up the project with your image that has the background removed, right click the layer, duplicate, change it so it duplicates into the 112 by 112 project. This will open it in your new project. Just hit Control T and resize your image using the edges here so it fits your new 112 pixel square. This is where you'll see if your emote is really simple enough, because it will start to show how small 112 pixels actually is. And if you can't see the edges used to resize things after hitting Control T, then just hit Control H and it should appear. Once you have this in, it's sized and you're happy with it, head up to File. Make sure you click on Export, click Quick Export as PNG, and then pick a place to save it. And congratulations, you have your emote. I'm gonna quickly cover the free method and then we're gonna get into uploading it in the best way. So the browser version is incredibly simple, but you will lose some quality as I keep saying. Let's show you that now. So you've downloaded your image off the background removing website. Now what you're gonna do is re-upload it to the new website. The new website is called Pick Resize, and there is a link in the description to both of them, so we'll go with that. Once it's uploaded, you're gonna hit continue to edit picture. Now the first thing you'll need to do is crop your image to be a square, so hold shift and drag a square over the section you want. And just like with Photoshop, when you have your square, you'll see what I mean when it comes to composition and making sure that everything is kept in frame. Once you have your square set up and your framing set up, hit the crop selection button. Then down below, go to the select a new size for your picture drop-down menu. Pick custom size, then in the spaces between, set the width to 112 pixels and the height to 112 pixels as well. Ignore all the special effects, change the image file format to PNG. A PNG just means that it's going to be a transparent background. Otherwise, if you don't select PNG, it's not gonna have the transparent background. Hit done and you can view the image to see if it's worked. If it didn't, go back and you can edit it, or just hit refresh to start entirely again. But if it did work, then save it to your disk, select where you want it to save your emote to, and you should be good to go. Congratulations, if you followed all these steps to the T, then it means you should have your emote fully downloaded and ready to be uploaded to Twitch. But just quickly here, I'm gonna say, if you enjoyed this video, if it helped you out at all, please consider checking out my other content. I upload videos weekly all about Twitch and Twitch streaming, everything you need to know. If this one helped you, or maybe even just consider chucking a like or a subscribe. Next week, I'm releasing a video all about better Twitch TV, which is a fantastic tool that every streamer, no, every single Twitch viewer needs to have. So if you subscribe, you'll get notified when that goes live. And I think it's gonna be pretty helpful, honestly. I'm really excited for that video. Really excited, actually. Sorry, we'll get back into it, and I'm gonna reveal is also what emote I released that got 11,000 uses in a month. So let's cover something simple, uploading the emote, just because I wanna make sure that all the bases are checked for you guys. What you're gonna do is you're gonna head to your Twitch channel, head over to the creator dashboard, you'll see preferences on the left, click that, then head to affiliate, click on emotes, and you'll see at the bottom tier 1 through 3, click the tier you want to upload your emote for, select simple upload, and upload your fresh emote we just made, and make sure it is under 1 megabyte or Twitch won't accept it. Add your unique code. This is the first thing that follows your channel prefix. So for me, say I wanted to upload LJ7, I would type in 7 here and it would come up as LJ7. Now hit save and wait for Twitch to approve your new emote. However, if you've been an affiliate for, I think it's 60 to 90 days and you have no strikes on your channel and you're in good standing, then your emote will be instant upload. Otherwise, it'll probably take 2 to 3 days depending on if you upload it during the weekend. Remember, it's also an American company, so it'll most likely be an American time zone that it gets approved. So now for the grand reveal of over 11,000 uses on my new emote, and it was LJ7. That's right, this little salute got used so much. If I wanted to know if people wanted to do a certain game or do a certain thing, I could say, hey guys, check a salute in chat. Or if anyone subscribed, people would do saluting rather than hype. It just turned out to be a really solid emote for my community to use. And honestly, I think every single channel needs a salute. I think it builds communities and I think it's better than a hype. So seriously, make a 7. Whatever your prefix is, 7, do it. As I said, LJ7 was straight up inspired by some of the bigger communities and bigger streamers, which isn't, I don't think, a bad thing. So don't feel bad if you want to use it as well. And just chucking it out there, again, subscribe so you can see the better Twitch TV emotes for next week. And so you're notified when our free animated overlays go live very, very soon. I just finished building all the panels and all the last little bits and pieces you guys need, and that's coming very soon. So keep an eye out.